IVM.
Company Tales. We have a new Hindi storytelling podcast where Madhuri Advani takes you through the everyday lives of women around us, be it your mother, not your mother, but generally, your friend, your grandmother, an aunt, and lots of faces etched across generations. The difference this time is these women come to Tapri to tell you their stories. Tune in every Thursday for a new story with a cup of tea. Yeah, Hindi mein, cup of chai. Kripaya dhyan dijiye. The language used on the podcast may not be fit for consumption. We warn you, tread carefully. But listen, yaar, don't be so conservative. Okay, I've solved the problem with space in Mumbai. The show is called Cyrus Says. Very simple thing. I've come back from Delhi. Lutyens Delhi, as Ordnob Uncle says. And there's so much space in the diplomatic enclave. All right, I just look at it. American consulate is the size of Parel and Dadar together. It's that big. So you can put all those people there. Belgium, which is a country you don't hear of so much. Belgium consulate is Khar alone. South Africa, which of course they've come to tour for cricket and stuff, so you know we know about South Africa, is about the size of the entire Andheri, I mean East and West. So I'm thinking we can just take a lot of us Mumbaikers and put them in Delhi. Let it become Delhi's problem. Let's reverse the trend. Instead of Delhi guys coming out to work, let's send Mumbaikers to live in Delhi. It's called Cyrus Says. We'll be right back.
Hi, I'm Sariyu Natarajan.
And I'm Alok Prasanna Kumar.
And we are the hosts of the Ganatantra podcast.
On this podcast, we speak to academics, social scientists, journalists and activists to find out what's actually going on in Indian politics.
On this podcast, we stay away from personality politics, intrigue and gossip and instead focus on the data, research and analysis that drives all this.
So tune in to the Ganatantra podcast, where new episodes are out every Wednesday on the IVM podcast app, website or wherever you listen to your podcasts.
Okay, we have a guest here called Namit Das, ND to me. And Sarji, isme kya kya likha hai? Let me just tell you. Indian film, television, web and theatre actor. The complete package. The Hardik Pandya. The Kapil Dev for my generation. Ian Botham. So you're a complete all-rounder. Indian film, television, web and theatre actor. Before I introduce more about you, you said that on your way here, you were thinking about me. Is this a fantasy and can we talk about it?
No, it is. It's a memory actually. I was just thinking back and I was going back. कि मैंने आपको कब से देख रहा हूं मैं आपको
ओके
नहीं आई विल बी वेरी ट्रूथफुल
आई एम नॉट फ्रॉम अ वर्किंग वुमन्स हॉस्टल और समथिंग यू आर फ्रॉम द विंडो ऑपोजिट मेरे सामने वाले खिड़की में समथिंग वन ऑफ दोस स्टोरीज या
एंड इट इज वन ऑफ दोस स्टोरीज बिकॉज आई हैव बीन सच अ ह्यूज फैन एंड
व्हाट आर यू सेइंग
यस ह्यूज फैन
फ्रॉम द वर्किंग वुमन्स
हॉस्टल And there's a distinct memory I had. I must have been in 6th or 7th standard and I was in Bandra. Huh. Yes, you said that. Oh, yeah, huh. I heard that. Huh. I remember seeing you in a car with your wife and you were so agitated. You were fighting.
Wife. That's that's clear. There's only one person.
And huh. that's my memory
or
of Sinus you.
Cyrus Saukar as Simi Garewal in drag. Because we also used to fight a lot. So okay. Was it him? Or was it her?
Could be. Huh. I remember seeing you and you were fighting with her.
Yeah, that's
And that's
possible.
The memory that I had. And then obviously the MTV images and then
See, this
all
memory
of
is
that.
To do with matrimonial alliance and not to do with comedy and MTV. Yeah. Sorry that you were exposed to that side of the personality. Oh, by the way, that's continuing. Huh? MTV career ended, but marriage is continuing.
What to do, yeah.
Yeah, but true story. So the way you said it, I know you're telling the truth.
Yes,
well, in those days, we used to fight so much. Now, I think with 18 years of marriage, we have reached a space where fighting is a little less. We are more like NCP, Congress and Shiv Sena. We hold hands and sit together now.
Everyone also learns. And
yeah, well, not the BJP. We are not clear. Not able to understand what's going on. Just kidding. I know that you're a card-carrying member of the ruling party and that's fine. It's a democracy. So let's quickly talk, Namit, about your background firstly. Indian film, television, web and theatre actor. You've been seen in many films like Wake Up, Sid. I mean, there's so many. We can't sit and name them all. But it goes back, your entire thing goes back to Mira Nair and Monsoon Wedding. Is that... That's very long ago.
No, that's not long ago, actually. Nee, galat information.
The Actors Association in Mira Nair dates back to over 4 years.
Kisne print kiya hai ye?
Sir, aapne khud print kiya mere samne. And you told me read it all.
Maine galat print kar diya.
I've never seen sir.
No, actually my association with Mira is 4 years old. Okay, let me even go.
Read it, sir. Read it and correct it. We are very fair and this is our version of the government.
It started with this musical that she has wanted to make. Monsoon Wedding, which was a film that and she directed
my sound
in 2003.
With the Monsoon Wedding was of lassi going down my throat, which is very similar. Sorry. Bolo.
So, Monsoon Wedding, the musical, and I've been associated with that for 4 years now. And
so, the musical is in the play musical?
Yes, the play.
Which is performed where?
It has performed briefly in New York. We have had workshops. Wow. So, life was...
A workshop or musical alag hai, bhai?
Workshop. There was a workshop.
And on the Monsoon Wedding?
On the Monsoon Wedding. And then there was...
So, how to teach Bhangra to foreigners is basically the real workshop.
So 2 months we had in San Francisco, and
not bad.
And then what was
Namit's role in all this?
Dubey. I was playing Dubey, the tent contractor, which was played by Vijay Raz.
Yes,
in the film.
Very, very interesting character.
So I was doing that part, and I do that part, and that musical will be opening in London next year.
Wow!
So I will be
in West End.
It will not be opening on West End, but a theatre in Camden.
Okay.
Which is the Roundhouse Theatre, which I am told is really respected and
did I say the wrong thing?
No, you didn't say
that. I only know West End, that's all. But you're right, there's so many different, areas, and there's a very vibrant theatre scene in England and London.
Yeah.
And also, in Jan.
No, it's next year, mid-next year.
Okay, so Indian summer, Indians visiting will get to watch as well?
Exactly.
Or is this more for the foreign audience?
It's for everyone, actually.
What about Brexit? Agar aap ja rahe to, on the way out, take a look at Monsoon Wedding and then get a flight to Paris.
Anyway, it's also a good time for me because Suitable Boy also comes out.
Oh, wow.
Then. So I will be in London, hopefully.
Okay.
And I am part
of
Suitable
Boy. This is the book, the movie version of the book.
This is the series version. So they are doing I've just finished the shooting for that.
You're the protagonist?
There are many protagonists. I'm one of them.
Okay.
So
my God, he's like talking to a politician. Ek seedha jawab hi nahi milta yahan pe. I go to West End, he goes to Camden. I go to protagonist, he's got more protagonists. Like, what's going on? This is like my wedding.
Abhi kya kare, abhi country ka mood hi kuch aisa na, sab political hai, what to do?
Yeah, left arm not so orthodox. That's the other show. Okay, I want to go back. We normally trace the, it's like a biopic but without visuals, and look at everything that happened. And you're very interesting that you've got all these different sides to your personality. Actor, of course, but there's also all the other sides. You belong to a family of musicians and singers.
Yes.
Classically trained.
Your
father was quite famous as well.
My father, I believe, is quite famous. Yeah. He's still alive.
Yeah.
And
I'm so sorry. I didn't mean it like that. No. Yeah, this is the most embarrassing interview, and it's towards the end of the year. Have we not progressed? Abbas, what's going on? Namit is kind enough to just laugh. He's already thinking, I wish the wife had hit him in the car was then.
No, Papa is he sings ghazals and has been doing that since time eternity.
Mm-hmm.
And very, very popular. And music is like in my veins.
Grandfather as well.
Yes, grandfather.
Okay.
Grandfather from my mom's side, who was K. Panalal.
Right.
And yeah, music is really, really my second
And also from
thing.
Your dad's side?
My dad is the only one who's the musician.
Oh, okay.
My mom actually comes from the Gharana.
Oh,
the Jaipur Gharana. Yeah, it's like serious business.
Okay. You got it wrong, the family tree, Abbas. But it's okay, let's not point fingers, it's fine.
As no, people,
it's
people
all
do
in the
get
family.
Confused.
As Karan Johar says, it's all in the family. That's the main thing. And we must always take his reference when we are in trouble. He's like the Premchand of 2019. You have to use his reference. Yeah, so you're a singer. Do people know you're... Can you sing a little bit? Or is that too much to ask?
No, I can.
Huh?
If you want.
Yeah, both gaon mein. Just
thoda bahut. Nein, thoda bahut.
Because it's discerning year ke liye.
Actually, aapko ye bhi tick mark mil jayega na ki gaata hai, theek hai yaar. Ye information correct thi, Abbas.
Aur fir, exactly, because maine kaha ki aap all-rounder hai na, to all-rounder kehne ke baad agar all-round kaam nahi karta, to I look like an idiot.
Absolutely.
Firstly, maine geography ko barbaad kiya, maine West End se Camden se West End, they'll come after me because of this. So just to show that you are trained classical. From a gharana, from a family that's trained. So, yeah.
So, just a simple one. So, Haal kaisa hai janab ka? Kya khayal hai aap ka? Hum to machal gaye, oh, oh, oh. Yun hi bisal gaye, is that enough?
Superb! I almost harmonized. Almost.
I
thought, agar by chance.
But that's the idea, na, ki album mein gaana dalenge, to pura dalenge.
Exactly. I love those. The music from that era is my favorite.
Yes.
Both Hindi and English. If you take 60s, 70s and that era, I'm great. Uske baad, it's just been terrible, yaar. I don't want to point fingers.
No, also, yaar.
Up to Bappida's opening disco station, or I am a disco dancer. Mm. And then after that, I just couldn't bear it.
Also, sir, we are the children of the 80s, yaar.
Is
80s,
it?
Yes, and 80s is very troubled.
Is it?
That's what I say. Haan, us time pe music or film, jo kuch bhi hai.
Kyun?
I don't know what
80s
happened.
80s mein kya tha? Ek hartal tha, pura 80s mein.
I don't know what happened to the country.
Mills ka hartal tha Mumbai. In 80s.
80s and the early 90s. I don't know what happened to the entertainment.
Oh, that's where I come from. Acha. Now I've understood what he's trying to say. Round Marke, he's come back to Camden. Fair enough. Okay. So now let's go back and discuss who Namit Das is. Let's start from the beginning. Namit Das ka journey.
Wow.
Kahan se, kaise, how did you land up here? So let's start. You were born in?
I was born in Delhi, lived there for 2 years. And
so
then,
the memories are not very fresh.
Yes. And then shifted to Bombay because Papa shifted to Bombay.
Correct.
And he got a music contract with Music India in those days.
Right.
And that's how...
That was a label, na? Music India?
Yes, Music India was a label. Like that. Very popular label, which is universal now.
Everything was bought over.
So, yes, then I lived in Bombay and then schooling happened. Main batata nahi hu main kis school mein gaya.
Kyun?
Nahin, I don't care.
School ke bahar kya tha?
Bhelpuri wala.
Bahar, fantastic. That's the main ingredient of school.
Bas,
having the right hawkers outside to get your stuff. We had a Kalagatta wala, superb, Ranga. He was so close to me, I could leave anything with him. By the time I could leave anything with him, matlab anything. I should leave relatives with him. Auntie ko pakro, main aate 2 minute mein. Because you know, Parsi speak Hindi anyway. So, you know, he would be holding her, literally, when we came back.
But I think life began for me when I went to St. Xavier's College.
Oh.
And that's what
Say which batch, huh?
Okay, chalo,
theek hai,
I'll let it. 2005.
Graduate.
2005.
So, you could be my son. You could be my son. Except you're
possibility.
Except you're talented. So,
possibility.
2005. So I'll tell you 93 pass out. So we have a 12-year gap, boss. You were right to say, sir.
That's right to say, sir.
You were...
And it came out naturally.
Naturally.
Yeah. You came in and I said, sir. Hi, sir. And then I was cursing myself. I said, yeah, sir, ko bolne ki zarurat thi nahi. I call you Cyrus.
Age bhi ek cheez hai, bhai. Yeah, Mr. Brocha, even better. So now tell us. But in school, nothing. No, I mean, you're from this musical background. You're from an artistic family. So there was no sign that you were an artistic guy, no theater, no nothing?
Well, school, I was introvert.
Your personality was...
Introvert.
A lot of people are like that. You hear that they hid themselves in school, or they didn't blossom in school for whatever reasons and change completely when they reach the right environment.
Also, what happens, you know, is that there is a lot of pressure from the teachers because you are that guy who sings, who's sent to competitions.
Famous family name, huh?
And also what happens if you lose in one of the things, you get hurt.
I didn't think about that. There's a lot of pressure.
Yeah.
Your father is a famous singer and you can't win the competition.
So that used to be a huge problem for me. And
har gaya?
Ek baar hara ho, phir uske baad jo hai, dar lag gaya.
Play the relevant music. Ironic as it may seem.
So uske baad dar
lag
gaya.
But how can you judge like that? This is some objective. One judge is sitting there and he decides out of 5 decent singers, he'll give one.
But that's not how I used to think then, right? I was a bachcha and I was like, no, I don't want to go for competition.
But mom, dad said anything?
No, mom and dad.
Would they come for the contest?
No, they were very cool, yeah. They were very cool and they were like, yeah, you can't take it to heart.
Seriously,
and all of that, yeah. But I was like, no, I don't want to. In fact, I don't want to become a singer. I want to become an English teacher. All of that.
My God.
I want to study. I want to, you know.
English teacher is fine, but what will you do for money?
Those are things that you don't
think about then.
Mm-hmm. But anyway, St. Xavier's College was really nice. And
but what happened in Namit's life that suddenly, agar school mein aapko wo confidence and personality, you know, outwardly personality thing didn't happen, to kya hua college mein fir?
Theater.
Kuch parivartan, something changed.
Theater. And if you remember, English Literature has that festival, the Ithaca Festival.
Ithaca, you're right. It had almost died in my time, but they revived
right.
it.
Right. So, Ithaca happened, and that's when I was directed by Nadir Khan.
Correct.
And that really opened me up, and that's when I realized
that. So, how did
that
you land up in Ithaca? How did that happen?
Through auditions, and all my friends pushed me, and they said, you can do it, you should. And I just wanted to sing. I wanted to become like a classical, North Indian classical singer. But then I just went for it. And I really liked it. I liked the experience of being on stage.
And what was the first play? or whatever, the first act?
The first play was a play which was written by my friend. It was about Nehru, Gandhi and Patel.
Achha, this meeting was in heaven. 2014 ke pehle dhyan dijiye. Ye 2014 ke pehle.
And so it was a,
and like I a comic meeting.
It was a comic meeting. It was one of those. And it was written by all of us. And I remember the feeling that I was really
you're shitting. Playing one of the characters.
Yes, I was playing Gandhi. I was shitting bricks.
Ben Kingsley downwards. You got a lot of pressure.
So, and the moment the curtain opened, and the audience, and that sense of the audience watching me, I just eased out. And I just knew that I had to do this probably for the rest of my life.
And man, that's what a long play.
The play was only 20
good,
minutes.
Good reception.
It was really well received.
Are you dressed in a typical Gandhiji garb?
Yes,
and all
yes,
that,
all of that. And then there was that cheap wig. Wo
ganja cheap to bolne ke zarurat bhi nahi hai because you're in college. Cheap. I mean, I'm wondering whether you take the professor's hair and say, sir, we'll give it back to you. So, but good reception. It's very important. That first reception, I think, is very important because otherwise you can get turned off it also immediately. Mm. So that first clap or people then talking about it, I presume ki canteen mein baatcheet chalu ki, hey, yaar, kya, tune
yeah,
kya
you
kya
were very
that.
Good. You
some
were very
girls
good.
Giving attention, I suppose.
Yeah, not that. That did not happen with Gandhi, but yeah.
Hey, this is not a political statement, brother. This is just an actor performing and there's an artist and the boys and girls exactly. Are both giving a little attention. Yeah.
So that sort of, you
I
know,
think, we need that chaap also in college, right? Huh. It's a time when as a male, you want to be known as something.
Something.
So either you're a sportsman or, you know, you're a boxer or you're a, you know, whatever, good at studies or you're an artist or an actor. You need that.
And Cyrus, for the first time, I actually got an identity. Otherwise, I was quite unknown
so
in school.
You know now what people at CIA are going through at the moment.
What?
Trying to get the identity card. Mm-hmm. Oh, sorry about okay, it. Going back.
So this is the first time people actually like started identifying me. And then I said, okay, fine, I can do this. And by the time I was in my first year, I was in my second year, I was already working outside. Mm. I was doing plays with Atul and the other companies.
But so Nader, who directed you, so after that first thing, you immediately got a good feedback from all of them. And they...
I did not get a good feedback for that, but it was a tough ride because I was struggling with English then, and it was an English play.
Okay.
I had 15 lines and 3 slaps.
Yeah.
By the end of the show, I think I had 5 lines and 2 slaps.
So, ek slap kyun nikala? Slap is universal, it's not a language issue.
Nahin, because when lines cut honge, toh usme thappad bhi nikal
gaya. Slap is connected to the lines.
Yeah.
Achha.
So that's why. So, but it was really nice. It was a nice fighting experience.
But it's even better if it's not your go-to language and your first experience is in a second language of yours.
Exactly.
It's even better for your confidence because when you get back to Hindi then, you'll be like, come on, now you don't need that language.
Absolutely right. That's the exact experience.
So your confidence must have really gone up when you moved to the more Hindi-speaking theatre groups and all that.
And the moment I actually came to Atul and I started doing theatre with him, and he actually gave me the confidence he said that, you know, you are very good physically. You're
1 minute, iska matlab kya hai? What did Atul do to you, sir? Please, I want everything. This is the point where you tell us everything and we'll take it forward. You don't worry. Tell us.
He meant physical theater.
Physically, bahut badhiya hai aapka kaam. Act without sound.
And he said, you use your body very well. Those were his exact words after...
I tell you, English is a very funny language.
English is a very funny language.
Did you meet Gopal Dutt Tiwari?
Yes, I have done a lot of theatre with
him. What are you saying?
I love that.
We've destroyed his confidence. Coming and working on our show for 13 years, a very erudite, sophisticated man.
Kaise kar lete ho, yaar?
Exactly. That's exactly what he says, actually.
So, yes, and then after that, I started working for different companies.
Now purely theatre only.
Theatre at the moment. Then I did a television show at the age of 19.
But how did you get the show?
Someone saw me.
Saw the play and
saw me in a play. They called for the.
Wanted a cheap actor and set it up.
Yes, they wanted.
That's how it happens.
Absolutely.
Ah, Shahrukh. What do you think it happened?
I got 2,000 rupees per day.
More than the podcast. Making me feel bad just to be alive.
So and it was big money at that point of time, you know. मैं कॉलेज जा रहा था और साथ में 2,000 रुपए मिल रहे हैं
वैलिडेशन है
बस अरे बहुत बड़ी बात है
इसमें एक्चुअल नौकरी है अप टू दिस पॉइंट इज लाइक एक्टर एक्टर
या टेरिबल शो टेरिबल शो it was an afternoon show that used to come at 1 p.m.
कौन सा शो है ये
it was called पंचम
on the famous Pancham.
No, it was Pancham. So, till the 43rd episode, I was a normal guy who had sixth sense, who knew what was going to happen.
ESP, huh?
Yeah, that kind of thing. By the 83rd episode, I had committed a crime and I was in jail.
But you didn't know you had committed the crime because you had sixth sense, not normal sense. Common sense.
By the 120th episode, I had become Krishna. and
was this because of change of government?
Yeah. and 148th episode, that's when the show shut.
But that's not bad, yaar. 140, matlab 3 saal ka run hai.
No, not 3 saal ka, 1 saal ka tha exactly.
140, or daily?
Yes, it was a daily. Oh. It was a daily.
Lot of work, lot of learning.
Huh. And it was really nice, yeah.
But money must have come in at least.
Money came in. The confidence came in.
And working on a daily means you'll never get a worse job in your life. So
yes.
Once you do that, everything is easy.
Yes. Also, audience was below 5. Yeah, above 70.
Back to comedy.
Same, above 70. Same. So
there's a similarity between above 70 and under 5, is it? There's a correlation.
There is some sort of a connection there, and that's what I figured with the audiences were watching.
Listen, the audience is listening, asked us to take a break. They can't take this show anymore. We'll come back and discuss more. We're at the point where you have just done Pancham, 148 episodes of Emmy award winning television. Coming forward is the rest of Namit's life when we come back.
Hi, I'm Satyajit.
Hi, I'm Racheta.
We are from the Open Library Project and we host a podcast called Paperback.
Paperback is a podcast where we engage with stalwarts and experts from various industries, suggesting non-fiction titles that contributed to their journey in a big way.
We've had guests like Anjali Raina, Dr. Marcus Rani, Dr. Swati Lodha, Ambi Parmeswaran, Apurva Damani and many more on our show Paperback. Find new episodes every Wednesday on IVM Podcast app, website or wherever you listen to podcasts.
Back here, the long break is over and Namit was just telling us about the pain. People don't understand who are not in the business that daily television is something totally different. I mean, there's a lot of pressure on a daily basis to put out something every day for the next so many days. And so his life was a circus literally for a little while. But uske baad, obviously confidence badh gaya because you worked in this very tough environment. That it was not sophisticated literature is another thing. Now what happens?
There was no work. There was no work because.
But now your face is seen, so it's easier now.
No, in fact, it was tougher because everyone saw me as Krishna, and everyone was like.
Their Arun Govil curse. Once you play one role like that, you can't get out of it.
Yeah, and in fact, I did not have work for almost 5 years, and I was also Rahul out
Gandhi.
Of college.
sorry.
I was also out of college, just out of college. High on confidence, but no work.
Theater?
And that's why I joined theater again. And that's when I called up Atul and I said, boss, kaam nahi.
Pehli baari pe 26 not out kiya maine, but I need to make money.
I need to do something with my life also. And I'm really going down. And that's when I came back to theater. I did more theater. And in fact, this time round, I did a lot of plays. I remember working on a play called Numbers in the Dark, for which we rehearsed for 8 months, Cyrus.
You couldn't find the numbers. Arey, bijli band hai. Numbers kuch nahi chala.
It was literally that. Was literally that. We used to rehearse in this small classroom in Bhavan's college, and we spent every day for 8 months. And then the shows, and then it was
a very long play, is it?
It was 1.5 hours a piece and it was an improvised piece. So that's why we used to improvise every day.
My God.
To actually come to a point where, you know, we would figure out what this play is actually.
Sounds exactly like my marriage. But lasted more than 8 months. So that play was another coming of age experience for you.
It was. And I got nominated for Meta, which is like
the theatre awards.
And that was
30 years in theatre, not a mention. For me, I'm saying.
And that
you won?
That's a very funny story because I went to the ceremony thinking that I am going to win, right?
Oh.
Because I'm the best, right?
Oh.
And I went in my pajamas. I was drunk. I was also young that time. I was 23, 24, okay? Oh. And I was like, man, I'm the best, right?
Where was it?
This was in Delhi. Okay. It was in Taj, Mansingh.
Wow, you went in pajamas to Taj?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And I was like, I'm going to win this, man.
People ask you, say room 147 or something. Huh?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And they announced all the names.
Or kaun the nominees?
They were...
Names known?
I don't remember them, actually.
How arrogant.
Yeah, yeah, I was that arrogant at that point of time. And then I was sitting and then with Atul. And when the name was announced that so-and-so person, yeah, blah, 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 yeah, Namit Das. So I was actually getting up to take the award. Okay. And then they said, so the award goes to Nachiket, another actor. Cyrus, I gave an embarrassing reaction there where I was like, I went like...
For those who can't see this, because this is a sound medium, he's used the F word 3 times.
I went all of that.
Loudly.
Yeah.
Sabne dekha, obviously.
And sabne dekha, and that's the last time I've been nominated for anything, actually.
You were preparing yourself for the August Gandhi Maidan protest, because that was your first protest about not getting the award. But why did you think you're getting the award for sure? You just presumed.
Because
someone told you.
No, I think I told myself that I am, because I'm so good in this play. But that's when reality hit me that I think I need to work hard.
Don't worry, national awards are next.
Inshallah.
Skip this. Fir aage?
Aage then, Nandini saw me in a play. And she saw me in Numbers in the Dark. And she called me up to audition for a film called Wake Up Sid. And I remember going for the test. And I was pretty cool about it. Yeah. And evening I get a call from Ayan Mukherjee, who's making his first film.
Correct.
And he says that, Namit, you need to be part of this film. And I says, I tell Ayan, there's nothing in the film for me, yaar. Dost ka, I'll be that guy in the yellow shirt.
Always play the third friend from the right one.
Yeah, wearing the yellow or the brown shirt, you know. I really...
That's right. They always have a bright color. Achha observation hai, Abbas. Please remember.
So I said... But then Ayan said, no, Namit, you know, it's a very special film. It's my first film. And this part is going to be, it's going to be good.
Iconic.
And you are going to, I know you will really shine in this part. You'll make it special. You will make it special.
Plus you get to see the lines. Wake up, Sid.
Absolutely. So that happened. That happened. And I'm so thankful.
So you are now in a Bollywood A-grade big banner film.
Yes.
Suddenly from nowhere. Two months ago, you're drunk and misbehaving in Delhi at a function. Uske baad, you think your life is almost over.
Yeah.
And then suddenly you get this call and you, in a proper big film with a decent role, as it turns out.
And it actually became, it became something as we were shooting. You
he
know?
Increased it.
He increased it, and he also saw, you know, portions where, you know, I could do stuff. And he was like, you know, and it was a great association. And on that film, the average age I remember, this was, I think... 10 years back. The average age must have been like 26 or 25. That includes Anil Mehta also.
Right.
The DOP. Everyone was so young at that point of time, and we didn't know what we were making, really. It was only at the screening that we saw it, and the whole industry saw it, and then we were like, okay, this feels special. This really feels special. And it is a very special film. And as the years have gone on...
And for the young people who have not watched Wake Up, Sid, let me just tell you that at the end, he does wake up.
Yes.
I mean, in case they're waiting for the final situation. So your life changes after this? You're on screen now in a proper Bollywood film. Your
life did change.
Picture is in papers. You know, people talk about you. They recognize your face.
Yes. And that recognition came. And then after that, a lot of ads happened.
Right.
And then that sort of, you know, started...
So visibility became more and more, is what you're saying.
That's what... It really... An interesting journey started. And I'm so thankful that Ayan gave me that.
So did you start drinking more or drinking less?
Drinking less. In fact, I've given up completely. I'm clean.
I'm also clean. Yaar, what to do with our lives, yaar? 6 baje ke baad. It's very boring.
I run.
I feed cats.
Okay.
You have cats?
Your choice. I have too many cats, in fact, in my building.
Many humans, yes. Animals ko mat maro, yaar.
Nee, I'm not... Yaar.
But how it starts like that, then someone says, get rid of them, and then some idiot does something. You have to be careful of all this, yaar.
I know that.
Let's hurt the humans. I'm all for that. You tell me when and where. No, I'm just kidding. All right, so now let's move on to where you are right now. You've done everything. You've worked in web. You worked, obviously, television. You started with theater. You still do?
Are you still
like Nasir, where you will always do theater, or you like many of the guys who do it and then once you get in fame and fortune?
Not at this point of time. I'm doing a lot of camera work, and I'm very happy to be doing that. There are some of the plays which I did like 8 or 9 years back,
mm-hmm.
and they still continue, and they are some of the most successful.
So you
plays.
Still do those runs.
I still do
when they
do those
want
runs.
To travel and this and that.
Yes,
Namit ko bola date nahi hai. Fir bhi, you must be having a duplicate by now. Great people have to have duplicates. Do you have a duplicate?
I have a duplicate.
Theater double. But theater I double to hai. What do you call it? Understudy.
Understudy. I don't want to call him a duplicate. Yeah.
Duplicate is in films. In films we say duplicate.
Ha.
Always say duplicate.
And my driver says dupe.
डूप बोलते हैं
हाँ डूप बोलते हैं आपका डूप है वो
क्या बात है
आपका डूप है
इवन ऑल क्लासेस ऑफ सोसाइटी इन इंडिया हैव बिकम इनटू दिस व्हाट इज इट दिस शॉर्ट टॉक टेक्सटिंग कॉन्वर्सेशंस वेरी वेरी फैसिनेटिंग स्टोरी बट व्हाट हैपेंड टू सिंगिंग देन इन ऑल दिस
सिंगिंग टुक अ बैक सीट बट सिंगिंग आई डिड अ प्ले कॉल्ड स्टोरीज इन अ सॉन्ग इन 2011
I remember this.
2011 yeah. with Gopal Dutt.
Correct. Gopal, that's why I remember Gopal, it. Yes, right. yes.
That brought the music back in my life.
But now that you're an established actor and you're a known face and you're a known writer and everything else, you don't feel that you can push that bit of
I do actually. I have a band and we have...
You play birthday parties?
birthday
Mira
parties?
Mira Nair's birthday is, he's turning 7.
We will you be interested in ghazals?
Of course.
Then I'm coming.
I want to make sure we don't do another birthday party.
Bahut
mehenga hai bhai.
Then I'm coming.
South Bombay politics is very bad. Yeah.
Then I'm coming for it. So I have a band with Anurag Shankar, this lovely guitarist I met 5 years back because of stories in a song.
Okay.
So it was a show.
So you're on tour?
Yes, we do. We do. We've done almost
the full
major,
concert.
The major indie circuit. Yes.
What are you saying?
Yeah, the major industry.
And you play, is it ghazals and that kind of thing? Or is it more like Kishore Kumar and retro music and is it a mix?
It's original music. So it's a lot of the music.
So aap composer bhi hai?
Yes.
Kya baat
yes.
hai, bhai?
I have composed some things for Suitable Boy.
Really?
Yes.
Which will play in the series?
Which will play in the series.
Wow.
Which will play in the series. And with Anurag, we have toured a lot. We've done NH7. We've done some interesting indie festivals in UP and Rajasthan. So
you're doing now, basically you're a composer, you're a writer, you're an actor, you're a singer, performer. What else is left? Director. You're now to direct.
I would love to direct.
So that's all that's left.
Everything I really would love to direct, but I'm really waiting for a writer that I can jam with.
There are no writers left. They've all left the country.
I don't know.
We'll have to look. Why can't you work with Gopal?
I would love to.
He's got a very
but
good
Gopal
mind.
Doesn't have any time.
Yeah, there's a word for him. There's a word for him. It's the oldest profession. Phone call comes, he goes to do it.
Absolutely.
Now he doesn't even ask his role. Kya hai. He completes the role and then he just checks.
Gopal, I wish I could do something with Gopal.
Yeah.
I really wish I could do something with him, but he just doesn't have the time.
It's unbelievable. Also, like you, he does a lot of different things.
Yes.
Like you, he also can sing and this and that. But anyway, chalo, theek hai. Somebody has to have talent. Otherwise, how will this business go forward? All right. Before we wind up, what's next now? You're still finishing Suitable Boy. It's going on right now.
The filming is over.
Mm-hmm. With my damn research team is saying currently shooting for Mira Nair Suitable Boy in Lucknow, as in right this minute.
But they're not far away from the truth.
1 week
pehle. How 1 week pehle
exactly. Khatam.
So so that is over. I'm working for another web show mm-hmm. on Hotstar.
Are you allowed to tell us?
Can't tell.
Don't
too
say
much
the name, but what
it.
Is character and all that? Anything?
It's something negative.
Have you ever done that before?
I have done that
villain
in
proper?
A show called Abhay for Z5.
Okay.
And it was a lot of fun here. Playing negative is nice.
Have you played a transgender serial murderer who attacks only really old people?
I would love to.
Because I have this character in mind.
Really?
When I heard you for the first time say, hello sir, I thought that this is it.
Go for
yehi
it.
Perfect fit. Hai.
Go
perfect
for it.
Fit hai. Listen, it's been wonderful talking to you, Namit. Obviously, you have too much talent to come on the podcast, so it's difficult to get you back again. But great to know so much about you. Want to apologize about the memory you have of me and my wife fighting.
Not at all.
I just want to tell you that she always wins. So don't worry. Uh-huh. Are you married?
I am married for the last 4 years.
4 years or progeny?
I think next year yet 2 saal.
Wo production chalu nahi kiya aapne?
Abhi
itna badi mention all around
time nahi time mila. Time nahi mila. Abhi.
Time nahi mila. He can sing songs for 2 hours in bloody far away corners of India, but he can't spend 5 minutes with his wife creating the next production. 5 minutes mein nahi, bhai. Let me tell you, as someone who has scored more times than Cristiano Ronaldo, 30 seconds. 30 seconds and play the ghazal, beta. Play the ghazal after that. Wonderful talking to you, Namit Das. We look forward to the series Suitable Boy and lots more. And hope you will come back and chat with us anytime.
Thank
and sing
so
a little
much.
More.
Thank
sing
you.
One last song.
Which one can I sing with you?
Sing anything. I'll try and... Abbas has got a very good voice.
Okay. So I'll sing one from... you want to sing?
Sing.
एक लड़की भीगी भागी सी सोधी रातों में जागी सी मिली एक अजनबी से कोई आगे ना पीछे तुम ही कहो ये कोई बात है
AMAs to follow.
Hey everybody, welcome to another awesome, amazing week on the IVM Podcast Network. If you aren't following us on social media, please do. We're IVM Podcast on Twitter, Facebook and Instagram. We'd like to thank our sponsors this week, HDFC Life and Paytm Money. Sponsors make this stuff possible. If you work for a brand which you think would benefit from sponsoring show on IVM, please do reach out to us. We appreciate that. We have three new shows releasing this week. Uncle Please Sit, it's a podcast where Tushar and Joel speak about and strip away the misinformation of fact-free opinions that we often encounter in public. Stay tuned for the first episode releasing this Monday, the 9th of March. We're starting a new podcast called Smile India, hosted by Shifa Maitra. This podcast is both in English and Hindi, and it tells us about the uplifting and positive news from around the country. Episodes drop every Monday and Thursday starting the 9th of March. And Absolutely Right is a graphology podcast. That's right, graphology. Host Aditi Surana deploys her superpower of handwriting analysis and unravels some traits and characteristics of guests, including me and a whole bunch of people from IVM who you're familiar with. Stay tuned for the first episode releasing this Wednesday on 11th of March. On Advertising is Dead, Varun is joined by Tarika Soni, the head of monetization at Snapchat. They talk about content in the world of social media. And people, Edges and Sledges celebrated its 100th episode last week. Go back and listen to that if you haven't yet. This week, they talk about the Women's T20 World Cup India versus Australia final. And on Begin the Journey this week, Ashish shares a short story on dreams and joining the dots in our life. On Simplified, Tony Naran and Shrikant discuss the World's Happiness Index. On Paperback, Rachita and Satyajit are joined by the host of Litnama, Lakshmi Krishnan. They talk about women's role in writing and fiction written by women. On The Habit Coach, we have a Women's Day special where Ashton talks about periods, PMS, PCOD, and other taboo subjects which shouldn't be taboo at all. On Geek Fruit, Dinkar and Jishnu switch things up and talk about some pop culture other than movies that they've been following, from YouTube channels to reality TV shows. On Mr. and Mrs. Binge Watch, Janice and Anirudh discuss Season 2 of Narcos Mexico. On The Empowering Series, Zarina is joined by actor Jim Sarb. They talk about the art of storytelling and his unconventional characters. On Postcards from Nowhere, Utsav shares some fascinating stories of Bengali food. And with that, let's get you on with your show.
Follow me at Instagram and Twitter on Bored Brocha. I'm so bored, I need your help. I need your love. I need your touch. Okay, just follow me. Okay, AMA time. Amit has joined us. He's got a strong cup of something in his hand.
It's coffee, man.
Is it coffee?
Yeah,
it looked like whiskey to me. So that light color tinge.
It's not it's like light transparent. At all. It's very
I can
dark.
See your fingernail shining in the glass ka thing, rim. Of course, my okay. social life is so empty, this is what I look at. Mm-hmm. Abbas,
yes.
Are you going to take us through the AMAs? You've got yes, lots sure. of interesting questions and okay. a new t-shirt with a reptile on it. No reference to any politician in India,
no.
go on.
It says I'm a nervous Rex and it has a
nice.
Dinosaur on it.
Very funny. You get it? Let me explain, Amit. It's my joke kya hai. Rex. Which is Haryanvi for rack. She's got nice rack.
Oh my God.
Oh, that's too much.
Wow. Okay, this one comes from Vivek Priyadarshini. Hi Cyrus, which set of fan following do you cherish more? Number one, large number of Bakra fans who knew little about you. Or number two, smaller community of Cyrus Says fans who know a lot about you. Diplomatic answers not allowed.
Well, obviously the intimacy of these fans is more, so we have to say that, because they scare you. Also, they scare me because they get things right. Like, they root for my wife, they root for Kunal against me, they root for everyone against me. So in a sense, they get that right. So I guess that. But with Bakra, the thing is, the nice thing with Bakra was I used to get like Dobi's son coming and telling me, right. Oh, show, wo gag nakli tha and all that, you know, giving me critic, 13-year-old boy giving me a critique.
It is a show which has broader
and it cut across class lines.
And the language is not a requirement for Bakra.
A requirement, and also you enjoy it just from the point of view of someone having a bad day or whatever. I guess we all like that till Big Boss turned up, and then that's the biggest bucket of all.
Kind of bad day.
Oh, of course, one day we hope to all be on it doing our podcast from the house of Big
from
Boss.
The house, yeah. Okay, this one comes from Rakshit Agarwal.
He's asked me to read the full thing because I often condense the emails. His question is, what do you think of new kind of pressure building around teens like me of being successful at an early age in the era of social media? We are surrounded by the stories of people who are getting fame in their early 20s. Now, every decision I make is revolving around how this will help me financially, and I'm just 18. When I talk to my father and grandfather, they seem to be chill and enjoying their marriages. Is it not okay to be average these days?
Yeah, I think the whole perspective is the issue here. You should look at it like a urinal, as far as I'm concerned. When you're peeing, if you pee really low, right next to your feet, you know, just keep it there. That's the metaphor. Okay. So instead, tell your father, look, this is a list of failures in my class, or people I know who've made no money, or going nowhere, or really struggling. And I hope to just be a little above them and nothing more.
No, but I think his problem is not that, right? That used to be our problem.
But the problem is that we are putting the peer pressure on them, saying that X, Y, and Z.
No, but he's saying it's not the father. He's saying his parents, his father and grandfather are chilled, but he's putting the pressure on himself.
Fair enough. So it's the peers around him, the internet, which is telling him that X is doing well or whatever. So I think he has to reverse that trend and say, well, let's look at the other people. Because the world is, it's just like how you look at these models and you think everybody thinks they want to, women, for example, oh, we all want to look like these perfect, you know, 36, that was my time, whatever the zero figure, whatever was this time figure. You know, it's just, it's ridiculous. You can't expect our kids to just look exactly like those girls who are photoshopped and fed nothing for 6 months and made to run around the Sahara Desert for 3 days and then come and model.
No, it's not even that. It's a lot of these Insta celebrities. Most of them are in their teens or like.
But how many of them are there? I know there are plenty, but how many of them against the population? How many cricket stars are there against the real population? The Insta
the
stars,
exposure
the ones
is a lot more, right?
But
every time you open your phone, they're right there.
They're there. They're there. But there's also plenty who aren't there. No, you look at it from reality. The whole thing is we don't have the reality perspective.
So you're right. From a pure
pee lower, man. You're peeing too high. Don't pee high. If you pee high, it falls on you. If you pee low, you can control it. But if you're 40, then it goes all over.
Isn't it more than it's ever been, like, in terms of, like, you know, celebrity influencers, right? First, there used to be film stars and cricketers.
Of course.
Then you got all of the cricket
Forget
thing.
Them. Those are guys
then
who are famous for a reason.
YouTube
you're talking about the guys who are famous only for the internet.
Exactly.
So
right.
That's a different category of people growing at a sharp rate, no doubt. But why do you look at it from the perspective of that? Look at it from the perspective of still, that's a very small number.
But it is a small number, but it's a larger number than it ever used to be, right? So I understand.
I did something with TikTok in Madhuwala. Very nice girl and all that. She's got lots of following and everything. But I don't know. Why should somebody want to be like her? You don't have to be like her.
No, you don't. I mean, no, but I mean, like, that's the general influencer culture in general, right? I mean, like, when it comes...
So it comes from within to not have that peer pressure. It's why you don't drink or smoke.
Yeah.
And everybody else around you drinks or smokes. So why you do drink and smoke when nobody else around you drinks or smokes? That's a better example. I like that example better. Let's stay with that. Edit the first one. But I don't know.
I think back in the day, the stardom was a little far away. Like, you need to be in the movies.
So you didn't feel pressurized. Now it's in your face. That's a good point.
Yeah. Now everybody's
also, you
making
relate
stuff.
To the Joe who's doing so well with his 20 lakh followers because you're like, I look better than him. I'm funnier than him.
Also, I have the same tools as this person. So why am I not famous?
That just sexualized everything. Really unnecessary. Could you find
gadgets,
another word?
Gadgets, I mean.
That also sounds a little disgusting.
Gadgets and apps.
Yeah. Yesterday's tool, today's gadget, tomorrow's app.
Yeah, but it's. So the thing about influencer culture generally, right, and about the influencer mindset, if you will, the people who are doing really, really well with it are not people who are influencers for influencer's sake. They're people with something to say. Right, and then they become influencers.
We should get a psychiatrist on to discuss the influence of influencers and whether it's more widespread than we think and whether it's hard to deal with because it's today's peer pressure,
right?
As you say, because it's right there in the internet. You press a button, boom, this guy's got so many followers. Why aren't I like him?
Right,
someone has to do something about that. I'm going to fight this battle for my people.
You yourself are an influencer, you know that, right?
No, there's nobody wearing dirty clothes out of choice. Okay, that's just me.
Okay, let's take one last one. This is from Puneet Srivastav. Puneet says, currently my life is just like Groundhog Day, same thing over and over again. Can you think of a movie that best explains your life currently?
Sholay, maybe.
Okay.
Especially the dead bodies in the beginning, all lined up.
Who's the gubber in your life?
I got too many gubbers. My sweet wife. It's not that bad. I told you, she's also still retained her looks for them. I think I married well, considering she probably isn't feeling the same thing from any angle. Yeah. The gubber in my life is this. There's this terrible, disgusting man who runs the club I go to, filled with malice and hate. He's evil. I find there's a lot of people, a lot of evil in them around, and those people scare me. Not just general people that we meet.
They seem to
actually
congregate at clubs.
Yeah, well, that's one example.
Management
there are,
committees of clubs, not just committees.
Yeah, so you know, when you give people power, it exposes you. Power corrupts, as they say. And I think what happens is that informal people become formal. I've never understood the reason for that. Mm. You're not in the army. Mm. So why should an informal person with an informal relationship suddenly become formal and officious?
Yeah.
Officiousness is a very petty quality. Mm. It reminds me of my great leader, Imran Khan, the Pakistan
great leader.
I thought I'd just put that in for some fun. Who said, you know, small men in big offices. And we have plenty of these small men in big offices, you know, like a big office, a lot of power. And then suddenly they sound like Napoleon. You don't have to. Although Napoleon had a Corsican accent, so he sounded odd in French. But why get into that? So nitty-picky, man. Nitty-picky is not even a word. Maybe it is in French. Or Corsican. Can you do that in Corsican?
What is Corsican?
You don't even know what Corsican is. You're a well-read man of letters.
I don't know.
Corsica is a small island just near France. Okay. Have you seen the Corsican brothers? Douglas Fairbanks Jr.? Released in the 40s.
There's a Robert Ludlum movie as well, right? The Corsican song.
My references are 1940s Douglas Fairbanks. Yours is Ludlum 70s, 80s. Yeah. And yours is what?
I didn't even know what it is.
You're the future.
But Amit, movie to describe your life at the present? Present?
First 5 minutes of Saving Private Ryan.
Ooh, okay.
Well, if they didn't save him, we could have ended the movie. You saved so much money. My favorite movie of all time is Cool Hand Luke, though. Paul Newman. Check it out.
Ah, that's a fabulous movie.
A man's spirit being broken slowly. Mm. It's like marriage, but on the outside. Well, what about you? What's your favorite movie?
Of all time? Almost Famous.
Ah, yeah. God. That's painful. Talk about internet revolution and oof, ouch. What a low blow, brother.
That's all the questions we have.
I think so. Let's drink something. Yeah. You're sure it's not whiskey, right?
Yeah, I think you should get something.
Okay, catch us on any of the podcasting apps, please. We beg you, we need you. Send us your questions on Twitter on Cyrus Says In, or you can email us, even if you're not female, on whatcyrussays@gmail.com.
Do you wish you were smarter? Well, so do we. But the next best thing?
We could make you sound smarter.
And to help you with this endeavor, we are Simplified, a podcast that attempts to break down the complex world around you with a little knowledge, a lot of poor jokes, and a ton of random trivia.
Episodes out every Monday.
On the IVM podcast app or wherever you get your podcasts.
See ya!
Filter coffee is a fascinating beverage. You need to pick the right beans, blend them in the right proportion, roast them to perfection, and slow brew at the right temperature to get the perfect cup. Which is exactly like great conversations as well. You need to track down the most interesting minds, get them into their zone, and settle down for an unhurried, unscripted chat. And coffee for me is always, always, always best enjoyed with friends. I'm Karthik Nagarajan, and do share my table as I meet some of the most interesting people I know and sit them down for a strong cup of coffee and an even stronger conversation. Join me every Wednesday for a freshly brewed episode. This is not Frappe. This is the Filter Coffee Podcast.